corrió punta de arena. Hoy aquí estamos en Paterson, subiendo la bandera.
Puerto Rico, yo Puerto Rico.
Pero que vengan todos, sí, sí, pero que vengan todos. Vamos a gozar.
Puerto Rico, yo punta de arena.
Oye, yo no me quedo aquí. Ya el invierno me está matando. Yo quiero ir para la isla.
Yo no me quedo.
Yo quiero que todo el mundo conmigo haga coro, necesito.
Yo no me quedo para
morirte. Yo me voy para morirte. Un rimiento más no quiero estar.
Yo no me quedo.
Yo soy boricua.
Yo me crié, ay, pero nunca olvidaré de mi tierra boricua.
Ni Rivera, ni tampoco como se baila en tu vez, su famosa bomba y su plena. Algún día volveré y a tu vera. A la tierra del gran torrente. Oye, puerto gordo del alma. Ay, ya quiero volver a verte. Oye, el torno del alma. Ay, yo no dejaré. Ay, de amarte. Venga el coro, venga el coro.
Puerto Rico, yo nunca dejaré de amarte.
Puerto Rico, yo nunca dejaré de amarte. Ay, mi corazón se quedó frente al mar. Ay, en mi viejo San Juan.
Puerto Rico, yo nunca dejaré de amarte.
Puerto Rico, yo te quiero. Puerto Rico, yo te amo.
Puerto Rico, yo nunca dejaré de amarte.
Yo no quiero volver a ver a la tierra de Ramito. Pero que mira, yo me voy para tu altar, oye, mi Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico,
pero que vengan todos, sí, sí, pero que vengan todos, vamos a gozar.
Puerto Rico, yo nunca dejaré de amarte.
Oye, yo no me quedo aquí, ya el invierno me está matando, yo quiero ir para la isla.
Yo no me quedo, vivo para morirte.
Yo quiero que todo el mundo conmigo haga el coro, necesito.
Yo no me quedo, vivo para morirte.
Quiero estar.
Yo no me quedo, me voy para morirte.
Venga todo, vamos a hacer el coro. Yo me quedo,
yo me voy para allá. Yo no me quedo, me voy para morirte.
Yo no me quedo, mi gente. No quiero pasar un invierno más.
Yo no me quedo, me voy para morirte.
Yo creo que no están cantando el coro. Los coristas no van a cobrar. Chutu y yo lo hago.
Yo no me quedo, me voy para Borinque.
Escúchalo, escúchalo.
Yo no me quedo, me voy para Borinque.
Ahora, nosotros no, ustedes.
Yo no me quedo, me voy para Borinque.
Ah, sí, otra vez, otra vez.
Otra vez, otra vez.
Give a shout out to our band led by Angel LaBoy. Thank you so much for your talents. And he was here last year. He supports us every year. So thank you so much for the band, the music, and keeping our culture and tradition alive. Vamos a unirnos, por favor. Grab some seats, fill up those seats, stay in the shade. Those who need a little suntan can stand outside of the tent, like myself. All right, we're gonna get the program started, so I do need everybody to come forward. The crowd in the back, if you don't mind, just come forward, please, so we can get this started. All right, here we have some treats, we have some good music, we have some awards, and then at the end of the program, we're gonna raise that beautiful bandera that we call from Puerto Rico, the red, white, and blue. So please join us as we begin this program. I would like to call up someone to do a prayer, our Councilman Luis Velez, if he doesn't mind. Let's go.
Vamos a hacer una oración. Me cogieron de sorpresa, pero para Dios todo es posible. ¿Cuánto lo creen? So, I'm gonna do my prayer in Spanish. But everybody knows that we have only one God, and the prayer will go no matter what to the Lord to bless us, right? Señor, te doy gracias. Te doy gracias por el día que tú nos has dado hoy. Te doy gracias por este sol tan maravilloso que resplandece sobre nosotros. Te doy gracias porque tú, Señor, nos has dado el respirar para poder ver este día, para poder estar aquí unidos, celebrando el izamiento de la bandera puertorriqueña en la ciudad de Paterson. Te pido, Señor, así como el cordero se sienta en nuestro escudo, tú también te sientes sobre nosotros. Nos bendiga, nos proteja, nos haga enseñarnos nosotros la verdadera unidad que verdaderamente necesitamos en nuestra ciudad. Señor, te pido que bendiga a los que están aquí, a los que no pudieron venir, que están en sus casas. Si están enfermos, pásale su mano sanadora. Y si están aquí, Señor, bendícelo en todo momento. Bendice tu organización, Señor. Bendice a los organizadores y que podamos celebrar que Puerto Rico vive y seguirá viviendo entre nosotros. En el nombre del Señor, amén, amén y amén.
Gracias, Luis. I'm going to ask everybody to stand up. We're going to do the Star Spangled Banner now.
Let's all rise. Let's all rise for the Star Spangled Banner. Sing with me, please.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed as the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, o'er the gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet raise o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
And that's why we pay them the big bucks. Let's give him another round of applause. Thank you, Andre. I would ask that everyone still remain standing. It's very important in this very moment that we acknowledge the passing of one of our greatest leaders in the city of Paterson, in the history of this community that's always been a supportive leader and steward of promoting the Puerto Rican and Hispanic and all cultures. Our good and great friend, the late Congressman Bill Pascrell. So let's give him a few minutes of silence, if you don't mind. Thank you. And he's here, he's watching us, he's with us, he's always with us. So now what we would like to do is to bring up Eli Burgos. He needs no introduction, and he'll speak on some things as well as give some acknowledgement to the dignitaries that are here. Thank you.
Hey, thank you very much. Que viva Puerto Rico! You know, it's bittersweet that we're here today celebrating the 52nd raising of the Puerto Rican flag, and that we don't have with us some of the friends that help us to do all this. Not with us here today, for example, because he's 100 years old, and he was the mayor when we raised our Puerto Rican flag for the first time. That's former Mayor Tom Rooney. No longer with us is our old good friend Frank Graves. Neither is Lawrence Kramer and Bill Pascrell. So we've been raising this flag for a long, long time. And over 52 years, we've come together here on the steps of City Hall, the People's House, to celebrate our incredible heritage. in this hemisphere, we reflect upon our European, Native, Indian, yes, Taino, and African roots, all part of what we are today. We're a people of multiple races, cultures, religions, and we embrace it all, which should set a good example for everyone else. Yes, I was here when the first Puerto Rican flag was raised back in 1972. And I remember people like, that only means I'm old, that's all it means, but there were people here like Esteban Martinez, the grandfather to Manny Martinez, Board of Education president. There were people here like Adela Coca, Sonia Rosano's mother. There were people here that were also not necessarily from the Puerto Rican community, but helped us quite a bit in those days, not only with financing, but with helping us get along. I think Peggy was here with that. Peggy, you were here, right? Flag raising? There you go, Peggy Anastas, the first Miss Puerto Rico. And I know that we have others here that were either a little older or a little younger, but as we reflect upon those days and we look at today, 52 years later, and yes, we all acknowledge that the Puerto Rican community, like the Irish and the Italians before us, they dwindled, and we came in and we took over the businesses and we took over the education system. I mean, we did a lot of things together. And it took a long time before we got our first elected official in Jimmy Avalo and his daughter Rita Avalo under the old form of government, but we came strong and we elected leaders who were willing to help us to move ahead. And that's what it's all about. If you don't have somebody in your house that you say, this is the person that can win, and then you can win with that person, you support somebody who can help you, you know, move ahead. And that's what we have done. So now, as we look at our numbers dwindling, and as we see other communities growing, it's up to us to continue setting the example for them so that they can continue paving the road for their children and their grandchildren to do likewise. What do you say? So, I was honored to have been the president of the Puerto Rican Day Parade during the first 25 years, and honored that the Puerto Rican community gave me that incredible recognition of being the chairman for the 50th anniversary of the Puerto Rican Parade only 2 years ago. But when you look at what we've accomplished, and Eddie, you don't mind me taking an extra minute, right? What we accomplished, you know, today we can say that we have a New Jersey state senator who's been in the legislature for 27 years, and Nellie Poe. And we can say that we've had a mayor for many years who was here, Joey Torres. And we know that currently there are three people with Puerto Rican heritage, Louis Velez, Maritza Davila, and Michael Jackson, all Puerto Rican heritage who still sit on that council, okay? And every day they're there with us. And we have council members of Puerto Rican heritage in Prospect Park, right, Esther? And in other communities along all the way around Passaic County. So yes, our influence has been felt and it's gonna continue to be felt, because as long as I'm around, I'm gonna try to do something about it. Now, let's see, I've gotta mention this because it's important. We have two distinct groups here today. We have La Vieja Guardia, and we have La Nueva Guardia. So I'd like to send out a special, special tribute and acknowledgement for La Vieja Guardia, who helped pave the way. And as I said, we have our past presidents, we have public officials all over the place. Humberto Cuadrado represents us in the Sheriff's Department so well. We have other members of other communities, Bob Guarasci, you know, et cetera, who with the nonprofits represent us real well. And only for the second time do we have an actual building named after a Puerto Rican. I mean, look, I think we all should stand up and say thank you, not only to the administration, the mayor, and the city council, but for naming the parking authority in the name of our great good friend, Tony Perez. Yeah. His many years of accomplishments have certainly brought pride to this community. I can proudly stand here one by one, our former, you know, undersheriff and warden, Phil Garcia, former president, you know, Arsenio Sanchez, former president, Ilya Villanueva, former president, Eddie, who's been leading this for about 8 or 9 years. And of course, I was honored to also be a president, but this doesn't happen in an isolated situation. Esto no pasa en una situación aislada. You know, it happens because we have great people who have led us. You know, we have our former surrogate, Toledo here, okay? She's always here with us. And where's our current surrogate? Where is she? Where's our surrogate? There, oh, there she is, okay? So we have fantastic people representing us. And on the other side, we have people who support us, okay? People like our council president, Alex Mendez. We have people like Elsa Mantilla, who's been with us from the very beginning. And folks, I can stand here. Oh, where's Ching? Rosa Ching from Passaic, who's a longtime leader. They should name Passaic after Rosa Ching. That's the kind of influence she's had in this county. So, oh yeah. Yes, I mentioned Maritza already and Louie, Velez and Mike. So what we have is we have a big mix. We have a big tent, and then we have other tents, folks. We have other tents. We know what the importance is of the right to vote. We know that. And we have a huge election coming forward that is going to let us know what direction the country's going to continue going in. And my Puerto Rico happens to be part of the United States of America, and we love democracy. And we want to keep democracy, and we want to go forward with democracy. But we also have another tent in this county, you know, which represents two different parties. And we welcome all parties, and both parties, by the way, have made efforts to have representation of the Puerto Rican community and Latino community. And now we have before us a challenge. I'm a state committeeman. I've been your state committeeman now for 35 years. I, with all those 35 years in the Democratic Party representing you in Trenton, I don't have a vote in this upcoming debate as to who's gonna replace our late great Congressman, Bill Pascrell. So we have people that have represented us. I'm not gonna say anything negative about any of them because they have represented us extremely well. Whether you're talking about our Senator Nelly Poe, Boricua, who has been there for us for many years. When you talk about Benji Wimberly, our assemblyman and our director of recreation, when you talk about Shavonda Sumter, an assemblywoman, and when you talk about the mayor who allows us with the council to be here and, you know, representing our community, Andre Sayegh. Oh, there he is. You know, somebody may say differently, but I understand that the mayor came all the way back and shortened his trip to Peru to be here with us, the Puerto Rican community, today. There's a price to be paid. When he gets home, his wife is going to talk to him about it, but we'll worry about that later. So thank you very much for coming. I'm going to continue naming outstanding people that are among us. We have commissioners. You know, I see Commissioner Padilla here from the Parking Authority. We have many other commissioners. We have Jimmy. We have Jimmy Rodriguez, who, my goodness, you may not know this. Oh, we have the members of our county commission, including Orlando. We're going to name them in a few individually because they deserve it. They're the ones who guide us. But we know we have an incredible assortment of people. Jimmy Rodriguez, by the way, if you remember way, way back in the 60s, he was only a little kid, but Jimmy was out there. I'm not going to say rioting, I'm going to say demonstrating on behalf of the Puerto Rican community, way, way back as a little kid, and here is still with us today celebrating the Puerto Rican Day. So look, we have a beautiful day. We're gonna be celebrating, we're gonna be enjoying ourselves, and Eddie's gonna continue with the part of the program. I'll be back to continue naming some of the outstanding people that are with us today. So a little break, Eddie.
Vieja Guardia in the new school, I wasn't sure where I fit. Old school, new school, maybe in the middle. Estamos buscando los jóvenes para continuar esta tradición de no solamente el aislamiento, pero la parada. Y queremos más gente involucrada y unirse con nosotros para lograr esta misión, ¿ok? So, con todo eso, quiero también darle las gracias a Eli Burgos. Como tú lo oíste, él está aquí del principio, del 1972, when it started. That's a long time. We're one of the oldest parades in the state, here definitely in the city of Paterson, and we have to keep the tradition going. With that said, I would like to acknowledge my family that allows me to do this work, because without them, I could not do this. Without my committee, I could not do this. But I want to give a shout out to my beautiful wife in the green in the corner, Jackie Gonzalez. My son and my daughter that are around there somewhere, maybe in the shade, oh, they're right behind them. So my family is the rock of my house, and they're the ones that guide me and allow me to do the things that I do. Here in the city of Paterson, we do a lot of work. Puerto Ricans have, as you heard from Eli, have led the way and paved the way for many other communities to come in. And we're not stopping. We have our beautiful senator who's here with us. Thank you for all that you do. Thank you for leading the elected officials in the state of New Jersey, also the leader of the National Latino Caucus, and we're so very proud of you, and we're gonna support you in all that you decide to do, and that comes from me and the Puerto Rican community. With that said, I would like to open the floor to our Senator Nelly Poe to come up and say a few words. We can do better than that. Let's give her a round of applause. ¡Viva Puerto Rico! Let's go.
Thank you so very much. Gracias. ¿Cómo estamos sintiéndonos hoy? Do you feel the heat? Do you feel the heat? Because el sol está con nosotros. Dios nos está bendiciendo con este gran día para poder celebrar lo más que nos orgulla como puertorriqueños. Esa bandera que es de lo cual nosotros estamos tan orgullosos. But ladies and gentlemen, let me just say to the mayor, to the council members, to Eddie Gonzalez, to Eli Burgos, one of our pioneers here, and to the entire Puerto Rican board of directors that have made it possible to make sure that we continue to celebrate what is so very important, that is our beloved island of Puerto Rico, and as Puerto Ricans, we are so very proud to be here today. I want to do a shout out also to not only the council members that I've mentioned, but I see that all of our Passaic County Free commissioners are present. Orlando, te quiero mucho. Sandy and Bartlett, John, thank you so very much. You are no stranger to anyone here, so we so appreciate it. To all of you, para toda mi gente, déjame decirle qué orgullo para mí poder celebrar y estar aquí con ustedes presente. I have had the honor and privilege of serving you in the state legislature for 27 years. And one of our beloved friends, a friend to all of us here, he was not only a friend to us, a friend to me personally and a friend to my family, but we go back for so many years. Bill Pascrell is someone who will never, ever be replaced. He was a person all of his own. No one could ever replace him that way. His legacy will continue to live on. And I know that even though he's not here with us, he is looking down. He would be here if he could. And we know that his spirit still lives within us. To all of you who knows him, especially those that played baseball for all those years, every time you all went to Puerto Rico to do just that. He loved those moments. I speak to him because he was truly someone who absolutely felt that when he was in our island of Puerto Rico, or whether he was there or here, he always treasured, respected our community, and always spoke very highly of the Puerto Rican community here in the city of Paterson and all throughout. But ladies and gentlemen, a cada uno de ustedes, déjenme decirles, nosotros tenemos una oportunidad. I'm gonna say that in English as well. We have, ladies and gentlemen, we have one up an opportunity to really be able to make history here. And I'm going to say that it is important for us to not lose sight of the fact that we have an upcoming election that is going to really make a difference, right? We have the 9th Congressional District is made up of 42% Latinos, 38% white, and I believe 8% African American. I have two amazing colleagues, Benji Wimberly and Siobhan DeSumter. I have run with, I've been elected and served your district for all those years. Together, we have been able to do so much together. I have nothing but the utmost respect for them. Everyone has an opportunity to really be considered. Mayor, you have been a champion for the city of Paterson. I've said that many a times. So I will say to all of my colleagues who are looking to be considered for the nomination of that seat, I would say good luck to you. Good luck to all of you. Of course, I am also going to say that I believe that it is really an opportunity for us to be representative of a community so that I can be able to move forward and continue the work that I have done in the state legislature and throughout. This is not a day of politics, but if we don't wake up, the day will pass us. So I want to be conscious and reflective of that and let you know that I am also running to be considered for the congressional nomination of the 9th Congressional District. I respect whatever decision our county leaders come up with and our county committee members, whatever it is. I just want my community to know that I have put my foot forward to doing just that. So I thank you. Thank you for your support all these years. I love you. You know that. I have been here every single year. I have been to every single parade that was happening at the time, not just for the Puerto Rican community, but for all my Latino community parades that we have done. So I'm not here and talking about this as a first-time person. I'm here saying to you, we want to be included in decisions that are made. So thank you, my friends. Gracias, mi boricua. Gracias a todos mis hermanos latinoamericanos. Gracias. Thank you to my African-American community. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you for being there. I am there for all of you, not just one community, but all of you. God bless you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Let's give her another round of applause. She's our leader. She's been representing this community, as you have heard from her, for a very long time. And we support whatever she decides to do, whatever the outcomes are, we're with her. With that said, I would like to bring up the mayor of this great city of Paterson, Mayor Andre Sayegh.
All I can say is, que bonita bandera. If you want to repeat with me, let's do it together. Que bonita bandera, que bonita bandera, que bonita bandera. Okay, we're on the same page. Muy buenas tardes, damas y caballeros. Bienvenidos a todos y hoy soy Boricua. Hasta la muerte. You know, we were talking about elections. I'm not going to politicize this. But we do have, remarkably, three candidates for the Paterson Board of Education who happen to be of Puerto Rican descent. You have Erica Plaza. Oh, right there. Hector Nieves, Director Hector. And Kenny Rosado. Very remarkable. But I want to take time to reflect. August 18th was Roberto Clemente's birthday. You know, we lost him at 38 years old. He would have been 80 years old today, this week, just to show how long ago and how young he was when we lost him. But we'll never lose his legacy. In fact, I'm proud we worked with Councilman Luis Velez, Council President at that time, Ruta Davila. The first playground to accommodate children with special needs is at Roberto Clemente Park. And I'm proud that we named the parking authority after an icon and the godfather here, Tony Perez. And I'm also honored that the day after we reopened Hinchliffe Stadium, we named the street where this gentleman lives after him, Eli Burgos Drive. Away, was it way, way? And it is with a heavy heart that I'm back. I was actually in Peru and I just got back this morning at 9 a.m. But I didn't want to miss, I called Velez right after I got off the plane. He was talking about garbage on 21st Ave. But nevertheless, we got it picked up. Right, Billy Rodriguez, proud Puerto Rican Director of Public Works. And I'm reflecting on the life and legacy of Congressman Bill Pascarella as well. He was a mentor to me. In fact, I started working for him back in 1995. So taking nothing away from anyone, I've always aspired to follow his lead. Go from being the city of Paterson's mayor to the congressman in the 9th Congressional District. So I've expressed my interest. And what I will say is this, may the best man or woman win. And so we are proud of our Puerto Rican community, who continues to contribute and add value to the city of Paterson. And I can say this with 100% certainty and confidence that Paterson is a better place because Puerto Ricans call our city home. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Andre Sayegh. Let's hear it again, both for Nelly Paul, for Andre Sayegh, our senator, our mayor. You know, when you have good leadership, and our Democratic Party has good leadership, it's all in the family. And that's good because we know that one member of this family is going to go forward and represent us and try to fill those huge, gigantic shoes that Bill Pascrell filled for so many years. So our condolences to the Pascrell family. We know what Bill did here in City Hall. We know what he did as a teacher. We know what he did when he was Director of Public Works. And we know that he continued right to the very end to let us know that he was going to be on that ticket in November. And so he's no longer with us, but you know what? His memories, all good memories, are here with us. So as the mayor had mentioned, and we had mentioned previously that we do have practically an entire contingent of members of the city council. I mentioned Alex Mendez and Louis Velez, who does a great job doing this with Maritza every year, and Michael Jackson. And we have, of course, I said Maritza, we have Fored Udine. We have Shaquem Kalik, Dr. Lalisa Mims. I saw her here before. There she is. Oh, she's got a front row seat, all right. She deserves that seat. And Ruby Cotton is here too for the fourth ward, Ruby. And I don't know if Al Abdelaziz has joined us yet. Yes, I mentioned Councilman Kalik. I think Al Abdelaziz, oh, he's got a lot of business to tend to because he is a co-leader of the City of Paterson Democratic Organization. So he's got a lot of work to do today. So without further ado, Mr. President.
We have also with us today a very special person who also broke some barriers in his town. The first Latino, first Puerto Rican mayor of Teaneck. Let's give him a round of applause. I would like for him to come up. Mayor Michael Pagano.
Thank you, thank you, gracias. As a proud Puerto Rican and the mayor of Teaneck, it fills me with great pride and joy to be here with you today for Paterson's 52nd annual Puerto Rico flag raising, because this celebration is not just about honoring a flag. It's about recognizing the spirit, the resilience, and the enduring contributions of the Puerto Rican community in Paterson and throughout all of New Jersey. This flag represents our rich heritage, our vibrant culture, and our shared history, a history that is filled with stories of perseverance, stories of strength, and stories of unity. And we honor the generations that came before us, who laid that foundation, and we celebrate the honorees today who continue to build upon that legacy, because their dedication to community, to education, and to public service is an inspiration to all of us, and it shows the way forward for our younger generation. And as someone who deeply values our Puerto Rican roots, I have seen firsthand how our Puerto Rican community has influenced and touched every part of our lives, from business and education to music and public service. And it's this influence that makes our cities and our communities stronger, more vibrant, and more connected. So today's celebration is not just about looking back at where we've come from, but it's also about looking forward to the future we are creating together. The honorees here today embody the very best of what it means to be Puerto Rican. They are committed, they are passionate, and they are always striving for more for our people. So as we raise this flag and celebrate this flag, let it fly high as a symbol of our unity, our pride, and our relentless spirit. And let it please remind us that no matter where we are always connected to each other through our shared heritage and our shared values and our beautiful island of Puerto Rico. I thank you for inviting me here today, and I thank you for letting me celebrate with you. Gracias.
You can't let him go without also honoring him. Don't go too far. So this is a certificate of appreciation for his work and his support in his town as the first Hispanic and of Puerto Rican heritage and descent to be elected at city council level first, and then again as mayor of Teaneck. So here we are.
Gracias.
We're gonna move on to our council. I would like to call up our council president, Alex Mendez, to say a few words and to be joined by his colleagues. Let's give him a round of applause.
Thank you. Thank you, Eric. Que viva Puerto Rico! Definitely, I feel that I'm in Puerto Rico. I feel that I'm in the island with this beautiful weather. But before we start, let's put our hands together for La Vieja Guardia. The Puerto Rican community, they paved the way for people like us to be elected the city of Paterson, and we have to acknowledge that. Eli, so many mayor, Joey Torre, former mayor Joey Torre, that he's not here, I don't say here, but Puerto Rican, like all of you, are paving the way. And we don't do this work alone. This governing body, we all together, and we promote unity. From my left side, I have Councilman A. Luis A. Velez. Let's put our hands together for Councilman Velez. I have Councilman Alex Furrio Dean. Councilwoman Ruby Cotton. Our Councilwoman at Large, Marixa Davila. Councilwoman at Large, Dr. Lilissa Means. Councilman Michael Jackson. And Councilman Shaheen Khalid. And I definitely have to open the mic to my colleague to say a few words. Let me start with a Puerto Rican from the City Council. Councilwoman at Large, Marixa Davila.
Thank you so much, Council President. I have to say that today, Councilman Velez, you brought tears to my eyes. You brought tears to my eyes in a good way. To be able to sing, I looked up at the sky, and I could just see my mother and the upbringing that she gave me. It is because of her, okay, that I am here. una madre boricua que me enseñó lo que es la responsabilidad y ser una mujer íntegra, una mujer servidora. Y le doy gracias a Dios poder estar aquí una vez más representándolos ustedes. Este es mi 10º año y es por ustedes que yo sigo parada aquí. Con Dios primero, no sé lo que mi futuro trae, pero yo sí sé que todo lo que voy a hacer, lo voy a hacer con Dios primero. Muchas gracias. Dios me lo bendiga. Eddie, thank you so much for spearheading this. Thank you to my political godmother, Senator Poe. I love you as well. Thank you for one day looking at me and saying, you should be an elected official someday. Let's get you ready. So with that said, to my colleagues, I know Council President, you're going to move on. Thank you, que Dios me lo bendiga. Y que viva Puerto Rico, huepa!
Thank you, Councilwoman. Our councilwoman from the 5th Ward, nuestro puertorriqueño, concejal Luis Vélez. Well, Luis.
Hoy saben que soy puertorriqueño, todo el mundo me dice que soy dominicano, pero está bien, eso no es nada. God bless Puerto Rico, God bless the Paterson community. As everybody knows, I'm the people's councilman, and I always gonna be with every community that I touch or they come and ask me for things because I was born to serve. And because I was born to serve, I'm not gonna speak a lot today. Because if I'm gonna speak a lot, then we're gonna speak all the way down to the next flag raising, is Dominican flag raising, and we're not gonna do that. But I wanna take my time to please, con el respeto de Eric González, con el respeto de la comitiva, yo quiero darle un reconocimiento. Ilia, por favor. Es rapidito. Primeramente, yo quiero traer al frente el Lifetime Achievement Award para la honorable Nelly Poe. Nelly Poe, please come forward. Honorable the Process Clark. Honorable Estelle Perez. Lifetime Achievement Award. Councilwoman. It's gonna take easy. Lifetime Achievement Award, Honorable Peggy Anasto. Si se encuentra con nosotros, por favor. Lifetime Achievement Award, Reverenda Airida Rodriguez, si se encuentra por aquí. Lifetime Achievement Award, Director Tony Perez. I'm not gonna read whatever, but they could read at home. Tony Perez, please come forward. Last but not least, ladies and gentlemen, nosotros, los puertorriqueños, somos más. ¿Usted sabe por qué? Porque los puertorriqueños estamos casados con dominicanos, con ecuatorianos, con afroamericanos, con peruanos, con Bangladesh, con las Naciones Unidas. La ciencia dice que el perfecto DNA son los puertorriqueños, porque tenemos de todo, por eso es que nos parecemos a todo. Y yo quiero honrar a una persona que sabemos que también tiene sangre puertorriqueña. Esa es mi amiga querida del alma, que cuando me habla yo tengo que escuchar, y ha hecho mucho para la comunidad, mi hermana y amiga Carol Cuadrado. Por favor, venga por aquí. Por eso es que los puertorriqueños somos unidos. Quise honrar a una dominicana puertorriqueña, entregándole la bandera puertorriqueña, con mucho honor y con mucha honra. Nelly Poe. Okay. Esto es para una persona. ¿Quién no ama a Caro Cuadrado? ¿Cuántas cartas de inmigración ha hecho para ayudar a nuestros inmigrantes a través de la oficina de Nelly Poe? Todo el mundo. Ella no mira color, bandera, raza, religión. cuando te hablas con esa palabra humilde, yo te voy a ayudar, te ayudó. Dios te bendiga mucho, hija, que prospere en todo así como prospera tu alma. Muchas gracias a todos y perdonen. A mí me dicen machetero a veces que me meto por donde quiera, pero Dios me lo bendiga. ¡Que viva Puerto Rico! ¡Que viva la comunidad! ¡Y que viva la unidad entre nuestros hermanos! ¡Dios me lo bendiga!
Thank you, Councilman Velez. Let's be brief. I know I allow members of the public to speak for 3 minutes at the council, but let's be brief. The program has to continue, but let me call another councilman from the Puerto Rican community also as well, Councilman Michael Jackson. Councilman.
Councilman Mendez, I would expect him to say, let's be brief before I come to the microphone. Y porque yo soy el concejal de mi primer barrio, porque tú no llamas primero. I want to say thank you to the number one Puerto Rican in my life. That would be my mother right there in the crowd. Y yo soy 100% boricua. And 100%. And I want to also just take a brief moment. And it's Councilwoman Perez. I want to take a brief moment to acknowledge this young lady, as the council just past week had voted unanimously to honor her for her work and her tenure, not only as an elected official, but as a school, as an educator, and all of the things, and standing up on principle, standing up on pride. I want to take, can everybody just give her a round of applause for her time to spend? And we will have you forward before the council again to acknowledge you and to honor you once again. I think I'm so proud of you and thank you for all the work that you've done. And great job, Eddie. Continue the great work. I'm going to be brief and be on my way out. Thank you. God bless Puerto Rico.
Thank you, Councilman Jackson. Councilwoman Alar, Dr. Lilissa Mays.
Viva Puerto Rico! Hola, mi amigos. Good morning, everyone, and good afternoon at this point. It is a great day when we can come together as family. We can come together to celebrate diversity and culture and just the fact that we can come together. The Bible says where there is unity, there is strength. And so I'm excited that we've come together as one today to raise the flag in unity because we are better together. Viva Puerto Rico!
Thank you, Councilwoman. For the football, Ruby Cotton.
Thank you, Council President. I just want to say I'm happy to be here. I want to say God bless you all. You know, what I say, going back in the 70s, the 80s, and the 90s, we, the community, came together, African-Americans and the Puerto Rican community came together, and that's how we got a Maria Magna. We all came together. That's how we got a Manny Martinez. We all came together. That's how we got an Eli Burgos. Because we all worked together to pull together to make sure that we was all represented here in the city of Paterson. And I'm happy here to stand here today to be a councilwoman 35 years later, replacing my husband to be part of the community. And I have always been part and will always be a part. And I want to say to you all out there, congratulations. You know, we must celebrate our heritage. We must always never forget where we came from. We must always remember what we do here. And when you come here to the city of Paterson, and as they say, we're one. It's no I, it's a we.
All right.
And we, the city of Paterson, can do everything together that we want. Eddie Gonzalez, thank you for putting this together. Outstanding job, outstanding. I'm happy to be here, and I say God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilwoman. Councilman Farrell Dean.
Hello, Puerto Rico. I know it's a great day as we are affirming our diversity. Paterson is one of the strongest cities in our nation because of our diversity. And today we are celebrating one of our territory and 52nd anniversary of the flag raising. And just know this, Paterson's diverse tapestry, Puerto Rican community playing an important role, and today we are here to recognize and celebrate you. We thank you for your contribution. Let's move together move forward together, work together to move this city become strongest ever, than ever. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Commissioner Eddie Gonzalez and everyone for hosting this amazing, amazing event. I don't have many friends like Luis Velez, but I have heartfelt appreciation for every single individual attendance here. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman. Last but not least, Councilman of the Second Ward, Shaheen Khalid.
Thank you, Council President. First and foremost, I want to thank Commissioner Eddie Gonzalez and his committee for putting together such a beautiful event. Paterson is a better place because of its diversity. I am proud to be a Patersonian because of its diversity. I'm proud to represent City of Paterson because of its diversity. Congratulations to the Paterson Puerto Rican community. Thank you.
Thank you so very much, council members. And let me take the time to apologize to the organizer and to Eddie Gonzalez. We should not take that long. But as a council president, I bring my council colleague. I give each council member the opportunity to express themselves in the community, and that's how I do it. I bring unity into this council. Once again, thank you to all the Puerto Rican community for paving the way for us as a new elected official to move on the right direction. I've been elected as a school board, now as a councilman, and I'm looking forward to move forward because I'm not going anywhere. I love the city of Paterson. Next week, we're gonna be doing the flag raising for the Dominican community. Next Saturday, the 31st. Let's bring unity to this community. Let's get all united. Paterson is a great city with over 52 nationalities. And if we all come together, Paterson is gonna be the best city in the state of New Jersey. May God bless the Puerto Rican community. May God bless the city of Paterson. Thank you, Eddie.
And just wait, before you leave, we do have certificates for you guys because we do appreciate the work that the council does. Despite what you hear, what you see sometimes on YouTube, I mean, that's just for entertainment purpose. That's all pre-planned, just so you know. They go to war, but it's all entertainment. So I think they get hits on YouTube and it brings money to the city of Paterson. So with that being said, yeah, just make sure we're all on the same page when we spread that lie. But that being said, at the end of the day, when it comes to representing our communities, Puerto Rican community, Dominican community, and other communities, they are here, they are present, like our council president said, and with that, we give them a certificate of appreciation for the hard work that you do. Thank you so much. Our committee will pass them out to you. And if you don't mind, stand in the front and we'll take a photo. Thank you. Councilman Alex. Councilwoman Marissa Davila. Just place yourself in the front there if you don't mind. Councilman Ford Udim. Let's take a photo here.
And as we do a photo op, I just want to acknowledge another giant from Paterson here because he represents us at the federal level. Our good friend Dennis Gonzalez, all the way out there in the corner. I think I couldn't see him from here, but I spotted him. And Eva Razak, where's Eva? Eva's always with us, day in and day out. Hi, Eva. Hi, Eva. How are you? So as we move forward, we're going to move the agenda forward. We're going to get a couple of photographs here that are very important. We're very, very grateful, of course, to our team from the county. Of course, in fact, while we have a couple of minutes, why don't you say a few words on behalf of the county?
Boricua, que se oigan!
I'd like to call up my council colleagues. No, I can't say that.
My county colleagues here, our county director, John Bartlett, and Deputy Director Sandy Lazara, our surrogate Zoila Casanova, our Undersheriff Humberto Cuadrado Boricua, ven pa acá con nosotros, papi.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor for us to stand here before you as your county representatives to share with you in this historic moment as we celebrate the 52nd flag raising here in the great city of Paterson.
Yo como puertorriqueño y único latino representante en nuestro nivel de gobierno del condado de Pasay, me siento muy orgulloso de andar en esos pasos de aquellos leyendas que nos abrieron el camino para todos nosotros, que en cada reunión, en cada edificio, en donde sea que entramos,
le damos una patada a esa puerta y dice, llegó un latino, aquí llegó un boricua y nos van a respetar. Así que boricua, sigue defiendo lo tuyo, defiende que se oiga la bulla y que viva Puerto Rico.
Let's give them another round of applause to our commissioners of Passaic County doing the great job as well, always representing us and doing what's right. That being said, we're going to move on with the program. I know it's a little bit delayed, but we're going to move on with the program. I think we're doing good. Here we are. We're going to give out some new awards to folks that you haven't seen before, some folks you probably haven't heard before. And it's all merited because of the work that they've done. The first two that I want to give out is very important because, you know, these are the folks who today, for example, have woke up probably at 7 a.m. to make sure that everything was in place. First, I would like to also thank some of our sponsors. We have Guillermo Garcia from ShopRite, who provided the tent and the chairs, and he always supports our organization. He does a lot for us, so thank you, Guillermo, and to the ShopRite owners. Also, to NJCDC and Bob Guarasci, who's here. Thank you, Bob, for always being a supporter of the Puerto Rican community and have sponsored many of our events, including today. There's also a Liga Roberto Clemente youth baseball tournament happening right now, and Paterson is beating the crap out of 4 other cities, I believe. There's 6 cities in the city of Paterson playing at Eastside Park, which we're going to go over to after, to hear some music, eat some food, and watch some kids play baseball. That being said, the two folks that I would like to bring up now who are with me here are two members of our committee, but they're pillars of our community. Some gente de la comunidad who has been working at this for the public school system for over 20, 30 years, have dedicated their time to our community, our culture, and our heritage. They're two individuals who have on their own prospered and grown into young women who have taken the leadership role in this city. We have with us a commissioner newly appointed to the Paterson Housing Authority. She's one of our very own, Tamara Lugo. Those are her daughters. So we want to give her an award for her accomplishments. She continues to serve the city of Paterson. She works with the library. She works with the churches on providing history. And thank you so much for all that you do. She actually retired from the Paterson School District, and she thought she was going to go and retire somewhere else, and we brought her back so that she could continue her work here with us. Thank you. And the next person, thank you, Tammy. And the next person we're going to give an award to is Erica Plaza, who also has been a pillar in our community, and many of you have known her. She's very boisterous. You can hear her from blocks away when she wants to speak, but she is our Boricua also, who's a commissioner appointed by the city of Paterson to the Arts Commission. And talking about elections, she's actually up for election this November for the Board of Education. So let's make sure that we get our Latinos in to represent us. That being said, I would also like to acknowledge two other candidates who are running. There's 3 seats coming up in November, and we have 3 Latinos who can take these seats. And it'll be the first time in the history that we would have the dominancy as it relates to the city of Paterson that represents us and our community. We have Kenny Rosado. Where's Kenny Rosado? He's right there standing underneath the tent. He's a candidate this November. We also have Hector Nieves. Where's Hector Nieves? He's right behind, waving his hand back there. So these are our 3 candidates running for the Board of Education. Let's support them. Let's make sure that they are elected, because it's not about us. It's not about the adults. I'm a commissioner on the Board of Education. I need help to support our kids. And these folks are the folks that I'm with, okay? So that being said, thank you so much, ladies. We're also gonna call up a young man who has accomplished so much in the few years that he has on this earth. Starting at the age of 10, he's won championships. He's won a championship in karate. He's won championships in many different forms of sports, and he's in boxing. He's only 14, 15 years old. I would like to call up Dennis Guzman. He is a representation of what we're looking forward to in the next decade. We're looking to mentor and bring up these young individuals so that they can be here at this platform. They can be here at this podium, making sure that our legacy as Puerto Ricans continue. And thank you for the work that you do and the leadership that you provide to your peers. Thank you so much.
take a second and say thank you to True Warriors Boxing. I want to give a shout out to Gold Time Performance, Caleb, Jose. I also want to thank the Walker Foundation for their donation. Have a good afternoon. Thank you. Wepa!
Also, we have food here on the left-hand side. This is food for all of you. I don't know if you know that. This is food for you to taste. This is from a Puerto Rican restaurant that opened up on Oak Street. It's Rodriguez Deli and Restaurant. He's here and he contributed this so that you can all enjoy some of his food. What do we got back there? Arroz con gandules, pernil, all Puerto Rican stuff. So come check him out. But I would like to bring him up as well because he's our Business Award Recipient of the Year. For facing some challenges, they had to shut him down because of some issues. He was very aggressive in making sure that he represents our community, continued to fight the challenges here in City Hall to make sure his doors opened up. And he is now an established Puerto Rican restaurant that we will continue to support on Oak Street in Paterson. Thank you. Would you stay up? We're gonna take a group picture afterwards. And please grab a business card or a pamphlet on the side so you know where his establishment is. The next person we're going to acknowledge is the United Puerto Rican Council. They're the organization of Passaic. We have our representatives come up. We have Felicia Rodriguez as well as Chin, the president. Now, United Puerto Rican Council have been serving the city of Passaic and its surrounding areas for decades. They are getting a cultural and heritage legacy award for all the work that they do. They continue to support. They have their own establishment where they host their fundraisers, a house dedicated to Puerto Ricans. They have been doing annual galas, and they've been close in partnership with the city of Paterson and other cities in our district. Thank you so much for all that you have done. Angel LaBoy as well, who's a member. I'm actually a member as well, signed up a couple years ago. But they do have the Cultural and Heritage Legacy Award. Would you like to say a
few words? Well, good afternoon, everyone. Buenas tardes, buenas tardes. Estoy muy contenta, muy agradecida de esta comité de ERI que ha podido alzar esa bandera puertorriqueña por 52 años. En Passaic llevamos un poquito más, llevamos 62 años. Sí, no, definitivamente. Porque esa bandera, como ustedes saben, esa bandera hubo un tiempo que no podíamos izarla sin ir a la cárcel. No lo prohibieron y hoy día podemos decir, alzar nuestra bandera y decir, somos puertorriqueños, somos boricuas. Sí. Yo soy boricua, para que usted lo sepa. Definitivamente. Nuestra organización lleva 46 años, llevamos dedicándolo a los jóvenes, a la educación, porque es importante el futuro de nuestros jóvenes. Y por eso hoy celebramos con ustedes, porque verdaderamente esto es maravilloso. Poder unirnos y compartir y ser fuertes y seguir adelante. Así es que muchísimas gracias, Eri, muchas gracias por darnos esta oportunidad. El concilio está ahí, las puertas están abiertas para todos, pronto tenemos nuestra gala y los invitamos a todos. ¡Uepa! Va a ser carnaval esta vez, así es que para adelante, ahí vamos, gracias.
And again, thank you to Angel LaBoy, who's the vice president, and he's also the one who provided us with the music today. Thank you so much. I would also like to say that Felicia also has her Puerto Rican flag raising in Clifton on the 7th, September 7th. Let's continue to support her. This will be the second annual event she started last year, and we're gonna continue that tradition as well, so one day she could be at 50 and at 75 years raising the flag. I don't think she'll probably be there, but someone else would. None of us, I don't think, are here. Yeah.
Failed to mention before that we do have another past president of the Puerto Rican Day Parade. Frankie Gonzalez is here. Frankie Gonzalez, thank you for being with us. Josefina Duran, thank you very much for being with us here today. And the fire department, I understand, is the one that provided us with all the ice cream. So hey, fire department. And let's not forget who the chief of the fire department is, un Boricua, okay? Got a great Puerto Rican there, who's the chief of the fire department. And by the way, the Maria Magda Hispanic Multipurpose Service Center is well represented here with the board of directors. We have Felicia Vasquez here, Ana Villalongo, Angel de Jesus, Humberto Cuadrado, and myself, and the others are not here, but we're here representing the legacy of Maria Magda, one of our pioneers. Angel Lavoy is also a member of that board of directors. Mr. President.
Thank you for those mentionings. We're gonna move on. We have our next recipient. Unfortunately, he could not be here. This is Nicholas Rodriguez from the Inner City Ensemble. The Inner City Ensemble is an organization of culture and art and dance and performance. Nicholas Rodriguez has been doing this for as long as I can remember, for many, many, many years. And yeah, since the 70s. And he's an individual from Paterson, never left Paterson, is a diehard Puerto Rican Patersonian, still providing culture, dance, and music to all of our youth and our community. In fact, we're partnering with him to teach our youth how to do theatrical dance, how to do the bomba y plena, and we want to make sure that we keep our tradition alive and make sure that our kids are hearing about our musics in the home. If they're not hearing it from the home, they're going to hear it from us. We have a great youth center provided by NJCDC and Bob Guarasci, who's sitting here, who will open up the doors for these types of new music to come in and teach our youth. It's not just about reggaeton, it's not about every other music, but we gotta keep our salsa traditional music alive, our jibaro music alive, and bomba y plena. So to Nick Rodriguez, who's not here, we have Tammy, who's actually a board member of the Inner City Ensemble, who's receiving it on his behalf. Thank you. We have with us the Puerto Rican, the New Jersey Puerto Rico Commission, established here in the state of New Jersey to make sure that New Jersey and Puerto Rico have a relationship. And I'm blessed to have been appointed onto that commission a few years back. I would like to give an award to all the board members, the commissioners, and the representatives. And here representing the commission would be Peggy Anastas, first Boricua pageant, first a lot of things. And she's another individual who has broke the glass ceilings all the way up to the top and, you know, shaking hands and mingling with past and current presidents and elected officials. Peggy Anastas is a leader, always bringing up her people, always supporting her people, making sure that she fights like crazy. That's what she's known for in Trenton, is making sure that she represents our people. When you see Peggy in the room, you know what she's coming for. Peggy Anastas. 1 minute, she says. This is not the city council, it's okay.
Muchas gracias. Primero, yo soy bien orgullosa de hacerte parte. Primero, la primera reina de Paterson y la primera reina estatal. Pero lo más importante es los amigos, todos los que están aquí, que somos familia, todos. And what I want to do is thank you. Soy la directora, la chief de la agencia, como se llama, the New Jersey Puerto Rican Commission. Y estamos siempre al día. Estamos ahora a ver lo que está pasando en Puerto Rico con toda la luz y todo. So, por favor, look in the papers, look in everywhere. We are the New Jersey Puerto Rican Commission. I'm very proud to have been since that the Governor Murphy appointed me since 2019. So thank you very much. I love that. I love Puerto Ricans and I love all my family that's here. This is like having a party in Paterson because I saw so many people. Thank you. Gracias. And I went to high school with him, with Eli, okay?
She had to say that. She had to throw that in. By the way, Peggy Anastas honors all of us because she has been a number of times a White House appointee. Okay, a White House appointee by the president representing us. And also, I want to mention that Puerto Rican, not New Jersey Puerto Rican Commission, Eddie Gonzalez is a member of that commission as well, representing us. So we're very, very, muy orgulloso de eso. Oh, and Nelly Poe as well. And I also want to say to Elsa Mantilla, I just want to say thank you very much because you're always here with your La Reina, La Princesa, always here with us. So we thank your entire compliment there that's with us. Oh, Roberto Cuadrado is also a member of the Puerto Rican, of the New Jersey Puerto Rican Commission. So listen, we are very, very well represented here. And I just want to say lastly, before we begin the process of raising the flag, that they need recognition. Oshin Castillo, the wife of our county commissioner, Orlando Cruz, served the Board of Education, I believe, for almost 10 years, twice as president. She's no longer going to be running for that position, so we want to thank her for her service. Thank you very much. You represented us really well. And also not running for the Board of Education, he's currently the president of the Board of Education, our dear friend, Manny Martinez, Jr. So thank you very much, guys, for serving. You deserve it.
Thank you. We have one more award to give, and then we'll have someone come say a few words after that. This is a person who I admire, an individual, un orgullo, que yo le llamo mi hermano. He's my mentor. He's an individual who's been a mentor to hundreds, if not thousands of families in the city of Paterson that has benefited from the great services that he provides in the organization that we all know as NJCDC, New Jersey Community Development Corporation. The CEO of this great organization, Mr. Bob Guarasci. He will be receiving the Nonprofit Legacy Award for celebrating 30 years this year of providing services to our community in the city of Paterson. Bob?
I only want to say one thing, because I practiced it. Todo el mundo sabe que yo soy italiano, pero hoy yo soy boricua.
Thank you, Bob. And again, NJCDC is a sponsor, but also everyone needs to know what NJCDC is doing. There's so much to be found, so many services to receive. We have a table on that side with a QR code. You can scan the QR code and see how your family can benefit from all the services we provide. Everything from housing, the youth center for your kids, programs, after school programs. We have health initiatives. We have a ton of things in schools, preschools. There's a ton of things that NJCDC provides. We just started a soccer program. Puerto Ricans, you know, they don't play too much soccer, but we're getting there. We're getting there. There's a few of us that do. So there's a lot of things to benefit from. Please see the table on the side where our young volunteers on the right are providing some QR codes. You can scan it and get all the information. We also need your information because moving forward, this is the way we're going to communicate with all of you. We're looking to do a gala soon. And if you're not on this QR code, you probably won't find out. So make sure that you scan the QR code for the gala and for all the future events. And I know, let me hear it if you want to see it. Do you want to see a Puerto Rican parade come back to Paterson? I don't think I heard enough of you. Do you want to see a parade come back to Paterson? Well, moving forward, we're doing that. We have a few sponsors already lined up to do so. Scan the QR code over there and make sure you get all the updates. We're starting soon, and where anybody who wants to participate, because to put a parade together, in my time, I remember the last time there was a parade, it was about 10 years ago. 10 or 12 years ago, actually, and I think we were in it. My son was just a few years old, but I think it's time that we bring it back, and we need you all to be part of it. So with that, please be part of this, and we're going to raise the flag after Carol Cuadrado says a few words.
Just for identification purposes, Carol Cuadrado is the chief of staff for the office of our Senator Nelly Poe, and also the wife of that great person, Roberto Cuadrado, the undersheriff.
Oh my goodness, I am so surprised. I'm still trying to live that beautiful moment. Que sorpresa tan y tan bella, Dios mío. And our Senator Nelly Poe asked earlier, do you feel the heat? Well, I feel the heat and the love today from the Puerto Rican community. Thank you so much. La verdad, siento todo el amor de ustedes. Es un orgullo para mí. Me siento muy honrada con este reconocimiento. Quería darle las gracias públicamente a nuestro concejal Luis Vélez, un puertorriqueño que sirve a nuestra comunidad con mucho orgullo y mucha honradez. Gracias, un fuerte aplauso para nuestro concejal. Gracias por tomarme en cuenta.
Quiero decirles que nunca he faltado una ceremonia del desfile puertorriqueño porque desde niña fui batutera. Muy temprana edad, recuerdo que ensayábamos en la escuela de la Eastside, en el parqueo. Así es que por mis raíces puertorriqueñas, mi familia, de parte de mi padre de Ponce, con mucha humildad. Y bueno, aprendí desde muy niña a comer, no solamente moro de guandule con mi madre dominicana, sino arroz junto con mi familia puertorriqueña y nuestros vecinos, que cuando mis padres vinieron a este país, en los late 60s, ellos, sus vecinos en su mayoría, eran de la raíz puertorriqueña, de mi cultura. Le quiero dar las gracias a muchos líderes aquí hoy puertorriqueños de la vieja guardia, como se dijo anteriormente, porque ellos ayudaron a formar a esta servidora. Eli Burgos, a nuestro former VA, Peggy Anastos, a quien escuchamos hablar anteriormente, nuestra senadora Nelly Poe, a Joey Torres, tenemos María Magda, su gran espíritu, sé que está aquí con nosotros, Tony Perez, oh my gosh, I'm gonna get in trouble, right? La familia García, la familia Toledo, también que conozco desde niña, así que gracias, gracias por servir esta comunidad con mucho orgullo y honradez. Estoy casada también con un orgulloso puertorriqueño que nació y se crió en la isla, es muy boricua y tenemos nuestros hijos, 5 hijos también, mitad puertorriqueños. Y bueno, él también sirvió aquí en la milicia y es un veterano muy orgulloso de ser puertorriqueño, así que muchísimas gracias de nuevo por este reconocimiento. Thank you so very much. I'm extremely honored and happy to be here celebrating this day with all of you. God bless you. And thank you to our great president of the Puerto Rican Parade, Eddie Gonzalez, for making this beautiful day possible and for recognizing all of us for everything that we bring together as a community. God bless.
Thank you so much. Con eso, we're going to start getting ready to raise the beautiful flag, our Puerto Rican flag that we have prepared there. I would like the committee to attend that area, please, if you can at this time.
¡Qué bonita bandera! quiero cantío, el indio bravío lo tienes también.